I'm here in Luverne, Minnesota. We are doing a showcase to demonstrate the construction process for one of the geosynthetic reinforced soil integrated bridge system, which is an Everyday Counts initiative for the Federal Highway Administration.
Constructions went fairly smoothly. The Minnewa Construction is a contractor on this job, and they've worked through. We placed the beams last week. As you can see in the background by the picture of the bridge, it's functioning well, and I anticipate that it's going to function well long in the future. And this location has been closed since 1993. We took the old bridge down. We've always had this location on our list of projects to do, but we never had the funding to do it. And with the assistance of Federal Highway and the Minnesota DOT, we were able to fund this project, and therefore we'll get one of our roadways open that's been closed for a number of years.
This bridge can save a lot of costs due to the fact that the timeline for this type of bridge is much shorter than a normal job that you, let's say, had concrete abutments. And the cost savings is approximately 20 to 60%, depending on your bridge type, length, and width.
We have a variety of instrumentation sensors installed at this bridge site to monitor deformation and strain and pressure, as well as tilt and overall settlement. We're talking millimeters or fractions of an inch in most cases for what we expect the movements to be. We send the data by cell modem up to a server, and then you're able to get the data. Basically, it updates once a day, so you have near real-time data and you can look at the trends of what's happening. What's nice on this project too is because it's a bridge where you're laying in the geosynthetic reinforcement in layers with just a few laborers. You don't have tall cranes and pile driving and a lot of formwork and other things, so it's easier for us to get in and work around with the contractor, so that's been really helpful.
This project in Rock County, Minnesota is the first project in the state of Minnesota, and it's an important one. We're doing quite a bit of instrumentation and monitoring of the project to demonstrate how well the project behaves for the state and for others around the country. These types of projects can be used on grade separation type projects, so one road going over another road or a road going over a railroad type crossing, or over water crossings. The reason the Federal Highway Administration is interested in this technology is because we have found that it saves money and time during construction.